Now let's go ahead and just take a look at a battery as we would at a counter test at the parts department, for example, at the dealership. We've got one battery sitting here, and I'm going to go ahead and connect the test leads and simply run a test. With the tester turned on, we'll select all the information, simply battery test, top post, group 31, regular automotive style battery. Now here we've got options. It says CCAs, but we've got 8 different ratings that are in here, including the DIN scale from Europe, the JAS scale from Japan. They all relate back to the performance standard, and they're all contained here in the tool. But here in the US, we're going to use the CCA value, and this is rated at 700 CCAs. We're going to go ahead and test 72 degrees, 66 degrees here when I get on the battery case, because we've got the infrared temperature sensor. That gives us a 3-dimensional view. We're measuring the conductance, which is the state of health of the battery, along with the measured voltage and the temperature combined to make a single decision as to whether or not the battery is serviceable. And here's our result. Good battery. We measured 12.6 volts, 678 CCAs on a rating of 700, and the decision is good battery. But let's see what happens if we don't use the stud adapters which come with the EXP-1000HD kit. I'm going to take and just remove one stud adapter off the positive side. And I'm going to connect to the stainless steel bolt. There's a spacer in the negative clamp that won't allow you to connect directly to the threaded stud. That's done deliberately. Here I've only taken and removed one stud adapter, and we're going to go through and simply retest the same battery, going through all the same measurements, all the same ratings, back to the temperature. And now we're going to retest and see how that influences the reading. We use stainless steel because of its mechanical strength and its corrosion resistance, but that's the same reason why it's a very poor conductor and it will negatively influence the reading of this battery. When you use the stud adapters, you can always be sure that you're getting the right call on behalf of the battery test. So here we go. Same battery, haven't moved. Replace battery is the new decision. We had 670 CCAs, now we're down to 596. It's a big step by just having one connection on that stainless steel post. So make sure you do it right when you're out there in the shop floor, making sure you test it right, get it directly. If you can't get on the stud base, on the base of that lead, and you don't have stud adapters, just don't use a steel adapter. And you can tell if you got your magnet there, whether or not you got a carbon steel connector or the stainless steel stud.